Hey guys, so today's video is going to be, kind of like a get ready with me. I'm gonna film after this, so I kind of want to just do my makeup and get one video done with. So this angle is really, really bad. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video. I did do a voiceover, so this video is a lot shorter. By the way, guys, I was singing and dancing in this video. Not like dancing, but like. Oh god, I have an itch. Anyways, but like going like this, and then I like grabbed my brush and I was singing in it. So it's very embarrassing, but I hope you guys can move past it. I was listening to music, that's why, but whatever. So yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Please make sure to like and subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. And if you've never seen my face before, click that subscribe button. I want to get to 100 subscribers, and then I want to do a giveaway to give back to you guys. So yeah, and I use very little products today, I noticed. But yes, and I'm so glad that this video is super duper short. And mind you guys, this look is not supposed to be like something crazy. It's supposed to be something like super wearable for every single day that's really, really simple. Like I did not, this video I don't even, I wasn't planning on posting because it's so simple and like it's really nothing to it, honestly. But I just thought it would be a great simple spring makeup tutorial, every single day eyeshadow look. So yeah, so I hope you guys enjoyed this video, and I'll see you guys next time in my next video. So yeah, let's go right into the video. Hello guys, so today's video is going to be a really simple kind of like everyday eyeshadow look if I were to wear eyeshadow every single day. Now my eyeshadow, actually, my everyday eyeshadow routine is with a different palette, but I don't know. I just want to do an everyday eyeshadow look that I would do using the Kat Von D Shade and Light palette. So yeah. So anyway, so we're gonna start priming our eyes, and I'm gonna use the Urban Decay Eyeshadow Primer Potion, and this is just gonna make sure that our eyeshadow stays put all day long. Sorry if you can hear me chewing. I'm chewing gum, which probably not the smartest thing doing a voiceover, but you know, we're gonna roll with it. Gonna get over it. Let's move on. So yeah, I'm gonna put this all over my eyelids and then blend it all out. Then I'm gonna grab the Kat Von D Shade and Light palette, and I'm gonna grab this kinda beigey type of tone, and it's just gonna help. I mean, it's just gonna help. We're just gonna set our eyeshadow primer with that. I meant to say. And I was gonna use my finger, but then I was like, no, we need to use a brush. So I'm using a brush. Sorry if you guys can hear me moving. I'm like trying to get uncomfortable. Ow. I just hit my foot. And then I'm gonna grab this really nice fluffy blending brush, and I'm going to grab this like beige. I keep on saying beige, this is more like the tan color. And I'm gonna use this as my transition shade. And I'm gonna put this along in my crease in windshield wiper motions, then circular. And that's just how you get a nice seamless blend. Okay, so my voiceover just randomly stopped. I don't know where I left off, but I'm gonna repeat it. Going windshield wiper motions in my crease, and then going in circular motions so I can get a nice seamless blend. Sorry if you guys can hear my TV downstairs.
Mm. Oh, and then I'm gonna go in with that like nice light brown shade. I'm gonna grab this dense brush and I'm gonna put this in my crease and then going back and forth and then circular. And I'm trying not to bring this too high up, but I end up bringing it a little too high up. So then I go in with my brush that we use for my transition shade and I kind of fix it. But you guys will see me do that in a minute. And again, I'm going with that transition shade. I bring it up a little bit too high for my liking, and then I'm just using that to kind of like erase it. And then I'm gonna go in with this small little blending brush, and I'm gonna grab, ooh, that really cute itchy nose. I'm gonna grab this shade. It's such a unique shade. I don't have anything like it. It's like a really dark, cool tone brown. And I'm gonna mainly focus this eyeshadow on my outer V. And then as I have less product on my brush, I'm gonna slowly bring it into my crease. And I ended up going in with tape just because it was kind of getting, I wanted it to be more like a cut, like a really nice defined line, and it ended up being more round than I really wanted it to be, so I just used tape, and that's optional. You guys don't have to do it. I just wanted to. I'm gonna go with that fluffy brush that we used to apply our transition shade and just blending everything out. And I'm gonna repeat the same process on the other eyeball. Other eyeball, other eye, same thing. And then I'm gonna go in with this. What brush did I use that for? Oh, I'm gonna go in with the same brush that I use for that lighter brown and that we use for our crease. And with any, I'm not grabbing any additional product, but I'm just using that brush to kind of blend it out. Because it is more dense, so I can be more precise with it. Then I was gonna go in with that shade, but I decided not to. And you guys will see me. I'm like, nope, I don't want that shade. So I want to go in with this really light white eyeshadow, and I really like this. I don't know why. And I'm using my favorite brush of all time to apply matte eyeshadow. This is one of my favorites. Oh my God, I absolutely love this brush. And it is the Sephora eyeshadow brush. I call it just the Sephora all-around shadow brush, but you guys can probably find it at a Sephora store. And I'm putting this all over my lid, and then I'm putting that white in my inner corner just to open up my eyes. My camera was acting like super, like it just did not want to focus out there, I feel like. And now I'm just gonna blend in that white with the cool tone brown. I'm just gonna blend that. Make sure that there's no harsh lines. And I'm just resetting my music and I'm gonna show you guys. I'm like, oh my God. also, guys, this eyeshadow look is very cool toned, but I put a pop of color for the lipstick. So yes, and then I was gonna do my mascara off camera, but I had to show you guys the song that I'm listening to. It's Pillow Talk from Zayn. I absolutely love it. It's one of my favorites. Okay, and then I am back with lashes, all mascara, with mascara on. And I ended up using the Maybelline 1x1 for my lashes, and I did not use any product for my brows. I just set them with clear brow gel. I used the e.l.f. clear brow gel. And now I'm gonna go with my lipstick. I'm using this one. I have no idea what company it is, but I will always have everything linked down below. But it's super duper hydrating, and I want to go with a pop of color since everything is like more cool toned. And then for my lower lash line, I'm gonna grab, yeah guys, I just want to show you guys. It's super simple and it's really nicely and blended. And I'm gonna go in with those two browns, and I'm gonna just smudge this under my lower lash line. And yeah, this is completely optional. With such a subtle look like this, I think it's completely up to you. I just like doing it because I feel like it just completes the whole entire look. And after I'm done with that, I will go in with the Maybelline 1x1 mascara and put on my lower lashes. And then I'm gonna go with my City Color Glowing Complexion Illuminating Cream. This is a liquid highlighter. This is the best liquid highlighter I've ever tried so far. I absolutely love it. It's only $5 and you get so much amount of product, and it's just amazing. Everything about it is amazing. It gives you like a really nice subtle glow. I just love it. And I'm putting that on the tip of my nose, my Cupid's bow, my chin, and the tops of my cheekbones. And again guys, if you guys can't find this anywhere, I will have everything linked down below. Okay guys, so then I'm gonna go in with contouring. And I'm gonna speed through this part. It will start speeding through in a minute, but I'm using the Wet n Wild Mega Glow Contouring Palette. And this is in the lighter shade, and it's gonna start speeding through it now. It's speeding through, as you guys see. So I'm just using this brush. I've been really liking this brush to contour lately because it just gives me a nice set of contour. And then I'm using this light shade, and I'm just blending it out with that because I feel like it does a really good job. And then I'm going to go in with blush. I have no idea why I'm using blush today, but I did. And this blush has really nice like glitters in it, so it kind of gives me that glowy look. So, yeah. And then after blush, I'm going to go in with my Rimmel London Exaggerate Eye Definer. This is in the shade In the Nude, and it is waterproof. They don't have this eyeliner pencil. By the way, guys, it's amazing. They don't have it on the Rimmel London website. They only have it at the Walmart website. So yeah guys, this is the finished look. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Please make sure to like and subscribe to my channel, and I hope you guys have a wonderful, magical, beautiful day, and I'll see you guys next time in my next video. Bye.